If you're planning to do a precise drone mapping, you'll need to prepare ground control points for your project. In this video, we will explain what ground control points are and how to place them. Ground control points, GCPs, are well-noticeable spots with known coordinates on the ground, in the area of your interests. They're used as reference points to establish an accurate position of photogrammetric data to a coordinate system you're working in. If you do a drone surveying and you need to achieve a high accurate positioning result, there's no workaround than using GCPs. Even if you use a PPK or RTK on a drone board, you will still need to use a few GCPs to ensure the accuracy of your project. The main requirement for a ground control point is good visibility so you can find it on your photos. Typically, it's around half of a meter by half of a meter, painted in highly contrasting colors to differ from the surroundings, and its center point should be easily identified. You can buy or create them yourself. Now, let's look at some basic rules of placing GCPs. The number of GCPs depends on size and landscape of your site, but at least 3 GCPs are required. All GCPs evenly allocated through the area where you survey. For example, if you use 5 points, set 1 in each corner, and the last in the center of the area. If your working area has noticeable elevation changes, try to place GCPs at the highest and lowest points on site. Secure that GCP's placements are solid, so their position remains stable and cannot be easily moved. Make sure GCPs are clearly seen from the air and not covered by vegetation and other obstructions. After you place a GCP, you need to measure its position. To do it, use an RTK or PPK-capable GNSS receiver. In this video, we use a Reach RS2 unit, but the workflow is the same for any other Reach device. First, configure RTK link. Watch these two videos to establish an RTK connection over UHF LoRa radio or NTRIP. All links provided in the description below. When RTK mode is configured, connect to your rover unit via Reach View app. Now you will need to create a survey project. Go to the Survey section. Press Add Project. On the first step, you can fill in a project name, author, and add a description if you want. You can also choose a coordinate system and vertical datum that you are working in. However, you can use default settings and just press the Save button. Now, you are in a survey project. Let's set your pole height. Tap on the pole icon and fill in the information. When you're done, press the Save button. From this moment, you're ready for data collection. Go to your ground control point and put your pole in the center of the target. In the Reach View Survey tool, press the plus button. In this menu, you can set the point's name, change the pole height, set the averaging time, and turn on Fix Only to use only fixed solutions. Before you start, make sure you level your pole using a bubble level. Press Measure when the pole is leveled. Reach View will measure the point for the chosen averaging time. Now the position of your GCP is measured. Repeat the procedure for as many GCPs as you need. Once you're done, go to Project and choose to export the list of your points. That's it. The list of your points is ready for import to Photogrammetry software. You can learn more about it in our articles on Emlid.com. The link is in the description below. Thanks for watching.